It was a pretty special night last night, being back in a room together after 2 years of COVID. Yeah. I had a good time. There were plenty of special moments, but wins for MasterChef, I'm a Celebrity, and Have You Been Paying Attention? And a beautiful tribute as well to TV legend Burton Newton. Let's take a look at the night's best bits.
Is Twitter still a thing?
No one in the room's on Twitter. Are you on Twitter?
I came to rehearsal, so I get to do the announcement.
And the TV Week logo goes to MasterChef Australia. Yeah, I think for us there's many people that we need to thank, but I suppose for me personally, the contestants, being one back in the day in 2012, I think it really does show what the show can do. You know, like I was an electrician 10 years ago, and now here we are.
Have you been paying attention?
We love making this show and putting it into your living rooms every Monday night.
Tom Gleisner, Ed Cavalier, congratulations. Most popular comedy program. How does it feel?
Excellent. It's so great. Exciting.
Thank you to the viewers who voted. Thank you to my Scientology overlords. Of course, may Lord Xenu reign forever.
For me as host, one of my great privileges is being in a studio every week with five incredibly, fantastically talented contestants, one of whom joins me on stage this evening to accept this award.
I've always wondered how much of Have You Been Paying Attention gets cut out and how much actually gets left in for the actual show.
Well, it depends who's on that week. If, for example, Marty Shergold or Mick Molloy are on, probably 90% of the show gets cut out.
Yeah, there was one week where Marty only all he got to do was introduce himself, and that was the only thing he said. Even that was borderline.
But other times, it's pretty much what we shoot.
What's the most memorable moment for you, Tom?
I love having our guest quizmasters on, and when they come out just before we come back from the ad break, I always ask them one very simple question: have you seen the show before? And generally, it's oh yeah. Yes, love it, fan. And so if I get no, I know we're in trouble. And I know this person will be calling their agent in about 5 minutes to have them sacked.
Where's your third? Where's Sam Pang?
He's up for six categories tonight. So he's got obviously our one. Yep. He's up for an AFL program he does.
Yep. We won't mention it?
No. Oh, no, you can mention it.
Because no one watches.
Yeah, we go.
I did want to acknowledge running into the 1967 Gold Logie winner Hazel Phillips, who's here tonight, 92 years of age. Bit awkward for Tom. It's always, you know, weird when you run into an ex. But,
Hey, he just mentioned in his acceptance speech as well that he's out of contract at the end of the year. You're going to have to pay the big bucks to keep him around.
No, it's more a sort of work experience thing. More, I think if you want Sam, just look for him on Gumtree.
Yeah, he accepts crypto dragons as payment and Dogecoin.
I'm a celebrity. Get me out of here. You know you're driving me. I mean, outstanding, whatever. No, because we've only ever been popular.
Yeah, but it's also a very big win for Ostrich Anus, which doesn't get enough credit in today's day and age as well.
Ostrich Anus, get into it.
Kitty Flanagan.
Kitty obviously couldn't be here tonight. So for the lovers of awards shows, this is a little bit like in 1973 at the Oscars when Marlon Brando won and he sent up a Native American. But
And the TV Week Logie goes to
The Project.
Well, The Project gang, congratulations. Most outstanding news or current affairs program. Must feel really good.
Most outstanding or most popular?
Let's say both.
Yeah,
let's say
both. Both. Yeah, no, we'll take that.
Both. Yeah.
Right. Must feel really great.
We're all thrilled. We're thrilled for the incredible team that we work with. I mean, the work that goes into our show every single day and every night when we put the show to air, we're incredibly proud.
I was saying earlier, it must have been the suit.
Clearly. That's right.
Without every year from now on.
Yeah, I have to. Although
no
we have
socks.
No socks. I can't wear socks ever again. It's really sad. We have a special audience, I think. There's something about the attachment that they have to us and that we have to them. It's definitely a both-way relationship. And I guess it shows up in Logies. So thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah. This is actually your very first Logies, right? You know, it doesn't always work like this.
That's easy.
I was going to say, your expectations are right up here now, aren't they?
Yeah. No, definitely. I feel like, does this not happen every year? You just don't rock up and... No?
Most years
for us, yeah.
Pete, how many Logies is that for you now?
I was trying to figure it out. I think it's something like 16 or 17.
Well, it does happen every year.
So, I don't have 16 or 7, like, you're certainly not gold ones. You can vote for next year. No, but it's a beautiful night. Like, it's a really fun night, whether you win or lose.
And you're still up for one more category.
Yes.
That's true.
How exciting. Well, it's very exciting, I think.
Yeah, I really shouldn't have this in my hand. And I am going to put some shoes on before that category, because
so
that
glamorous.
Was a mistake. I was not meant to go up there shoeless.
It's automatic. Hands-free bag, pop the gas and don't hit the brake, locked and loaded.
Tonight, I would like to take this opportunity to say to all of the dedicated writers, directors, casts and crews who've made all those amazing Australian programs over the last couple of years, enough. Just give it a bone. Sooner or later, Australia is going to need to get off the couch.
Even if you think you're not going to win tonight, don't start ripping into the red wine. Even if you're really sure you're not going to win, don't start ripping into the red... I'm not apologising for being drunk. At least I was drunk late at night at an awards ceremony where it belonged.
This is definitely getting more powerful by the minute here.
Hold on,
do us all a favour and let go.
And the TV Week Logie goes to
Gogglebox Australia.
Brittany Higgins interviewed the project.
After 40 years in journalism, this interview and this story is by far the most important work I have ever done.
Without you, I'm nothing.
The Logie goes to Hamish Blake.
Without you.
Well, Paddy Newton, it's so special seeing you here tonight to award the Bert Newton Most Popular Presenter to Hamish Blake.
Yes, I was absolutely thrilled. I was very emotional when I first started because everyone was so welcoming and lovely. Thank you very much for that beautiful welcome and for this beautiful man of mine. Isn't he fabulous? I mean, what am I going to do without him? I think Hamish was a very good choice for Bert's first award. He would have been thrilled about that. He's a lovely man and he spoke beautifully.
This is so special. Thank you, Paddy. I don't think I'm the only one in the room that's a bit emotional.
And it's such a fantastic way of honouring Bert as well, isn't it?
Well, Bert had this fear that he might have been forgotten. And I said, look, he won't be forgotten. That'll be fine. But he can't be forgotten now. I don't think he'll ever be forgotten anyway. Not by me. I'm wearing him around my neck. Lauren made me a Bert. So I'm going to wear it forever and I'll always have him with me.
For you personally, it must be great to be back on the red carpet up here on the Gold Coast as well.
It was, yes. I lost the sole of my shoe. I had an eyelash that was falling off. But apart from that, it was pretty fabulous.
And the winner of the Gold Logie for 2022 is... Hamish Blake!
Well, Hamish, you said it. Fool's Gold. Is that the headline?
Do you know, that was the newspaper headline 10 years ago. And that was the front page my grandma had. She got the commemorative thing of the paper and it was in her kitchen. And I was like, I'm sure there were other headlines. You don't have to have the Fool's Gold one. But she kept it.
Now, listen, I'm blonde and I'm a journalist, therefore I'm no good at maths. Explain to me how you have four now.
Yes, sorry, that's a tiny inscription. You might be able to pick it up on the camera. But yes, because there wasn't a Gold Logie in 2020 or 2021, it says here they jackpotted. So this one's worth three. So that's under Powerball rules. This is worth three, plus I have another one, so that's quad gold. Yeah, make that the headline. He's got the body.
Well, try. So Tom Gleeson famously put his Gold Logie on the Toba. Have you thought of somewhere imaginative for this latest?
This, my other from 10 years ago, that God Logie lives at Mum's house. And I think I'll offer this one to Dad. And then he'll probably go, oh, I'm all right, mate. We've got a lot of stuff at the house. And so then this will go to Mum's after that.
I love it. But yeah, fine.
Yeah, that's, you know what I think is good, but, you know, it doesn't really match the aesthetic.
Now, the gold is big, but you also did win the inaugural Bert Newton Silver Logie for Most Popular Presenter, and your speech was beautiful.
There will never be another Bert, but there are hundreds of people in this room that know the other side of Bert too, the generous side, the kind side, the support that he gave to so many people, myself included, but there would be hundreds of us in the room, the support and the generosity he showed. So I hope that's what this award stands for too.
I really think that one means something really special, yeah.
It really did. I mean, obviously not to take anything away from the gold, because I think Bert would not like it if I took anything away from
the gold.
He would
not.
He would like the full respect to go to the gold. But to be the first person to receive that award under that name in honour of Bert, yeah, that was a massively special moment.
Is his a career you'd like to emulate? Well, worked a bit harder than you. Is that a fair thing to say?
Yeah, you look at that package.
Do you know what I mean?
Oh, man, you look at how much he hosted. I'm like, oh, my God, I'm doing like 5 weeks a year. I mean, no one can ever emulate Bert, because there'll only ever be one Bert. But I think what I loved about Bert was he just had a ball. He was having a ball. And I love doing TV like that. So if I can be any kind of like tiny little shade of that, I think that's Bert's spirit.
Give me your best. Here's Moira.
Here's Moira.